I'm Ann Meyer with Adecco TV. Today we're joined by Carl Ulrichs, a consultant with Gregory and Appel. We're going to talk a little bit about CFOs today. Thanks for being with us.
My pleasure.
Well, let's talk about why it's so important for the HR professional to understand the mindset of a CFO.
Because they're so different. Most HR people want a project to impact the workforce. They've got the buy-in of the president. They don't have the buy-in of the CFO, the project won't get done. So it's pure and simple finance, it's money.
So explain the dynamic a little bit between the HR professional and the CFO and how that relationship is crucial to the overall success of a company.
Simply put, there often isn't a dynamic. The CFOs don't come out much. They hide behind their desk looking at their Excel spreadsheets. They, by nature, you know, if we want to paint with broad brushstrokes, it's a very cautious, introverted culture where it's themselves seeing their role as being deputy presidents and in charge of doing the right thing carefully instead of a fast decision quickly.
So if you can, describe a little bit the historical nature of the HR-CFO relationship and how it sort of evolved over time.
Fair enough. Used to be they didn't talk much, but about 8 years ago, the human resources community wanted to rebrand themselves again. They had been personnel, then they became HR. They were kind of chafing at the bit with the human resources brand, and they wanted to change themselves to human capital. Well, the CFOs perked up and said, capital? That's me. You know, there's financial capital, there's human capital. And over the last 7 or 8 years, a large number of human resources professionals find themselves reporting up to administration and finance, as opposed to reporting up through operations or the president.
Well, I'm guessing that's changed a lot even in the last few years because of everything that's happening in the economy.
It has. As things have gotten flatter, there's less give in the organization, but also as the chief financial officer looks at the largest expenditures of the organization, right up there, you know, aside from bricks and mortar and the cost of goods, right up there is the cost of the personnel, so we've got salaries, and right under that is health insurance. And those are huge checks that they're writing that they don't feel they have good control over, so they want control over it. I'd like human resources to report to me, and we're going to get to the bottom of why health insurance keeps going up every year, yet people still get sick.
Well, how can better understanding the CFO's mission lead to success and having the HR professional better understand that role?
Real easy. If you have an enemy, keep them close. If you need to get your human resources proposals through and implemented and make an impact, build a relationship with the person with the checkbook. And it's more than getting the president to buy into it, because quite often the president is strategic. Quite often the president gets it. Seldom the CFO gets it, because many times the points that human resources makes are, oh, this is great for our self-esteem. This is great for our engagement. This is great for, insert soft, cuddly word here. Well, the CFO wants hard metrics. Show me proof where a wellness plan actually saves us money. And they're getting to the point they can do that now, but let's use wellness plans as a case in point. It takes 6 or 7 years for a wellness plan to pay back. They look at their staffing and see that their turnover is every 3 years. And the CFO will rightly think, I'm making someone healthy for their next employer. We're not doing this.
So it's difficult, but talk about some best practices that really help build that relationship between the CFO and HR professional.
The best thing you can do is understand that the CFO is not going to change their communication pattern to talk with you. If this is important, you have to learn their language. Go to a financial practices for non-HR, non-financial managers. Start using their terms. For instance, I'm learning Spanish now. It's very handy. Learn their language and speak it. We would say before, this will affect the bottom line. And the CFO thinks, well, which bottom line? There's four. So learn how they describe the bottom line. For instance, the first one you generally hit is called EBITDA. Instead of saying this will affect the bottom line, say this will affect EBITDA. And all the CFOs who are watching this just went, ooh, they like that. Learn the language. It's pure and simple the best way to do it. Second, learn the way that they justify something and use that structure. If they have an Excel spreadsheet they've already built that they're going to evaluate, use their spreadsheet to sell your new staffing system. And then finally, they have a style that is a slow decision. So don't come in quickly expecting a fast yes answer. Send them an email, send them a Twitter, send them an article from a white paper from this website about justifying a new staffing system. And do that a month ahead of time and then a week ahead of time. So when you're talking with them, they feel comfortable that you've spent some time building the case.
Carl, thank you very much.
My pleasure.
Of course, you can find out more from SHRM by going to adecousa.com.